In today's video, we are going to show you how to make your videos look like from this to this. Hey guys, we are back with a bang and again with something very interesting and informative. This is Arshia Ali Khan and today I'm going to show you how to make your videos look stunning and professional. We are going to explain you the entire process in detail from shoot to post-production. This is going to be a little lengthy video, so make sure you watch till the end so that you don't miss out on anything. So grab your gear and let's get started. First of all, let's talk about the camera settings. We are using Sony A7R Mark II with 55mm lens. We are shooting in 4K mode, that is XAVCS 4K in file format. Do not worry if you don't have a high budget camera. We are also showing you settings so you can get the best results in an entry level camera. We are shooting in 4K mode. If your camera doesn't record 4K, you can also shoot in full HD mode. And according to the lighting condition and the kind of video you're shooting, you can set the ISO, shutter speed and aperture. Make sure you keep your ISO range somewhere between 100 to 200 to avoid noise in your video. Now we need to choose log profile. Go to menu, picture profile and choose picture profile 7, which combines S gamut and S log 2. We are using this to increase more dynamic range in your video. So here's a quick explanation about dynamic range. Dynamic range is the information between the darkest part of your image and the brightest part. It will allow you to preserve more shadow details and tonal range. This will help you a lot while color grading. So it's very important setting. So you should change before shooting. In the upcoming video, we will cover detailed explanation about dynamic range and log in different cameras. If your camera does not have a log profile, all you can do is to fake your own. We will show it to you how. Go to menu picture style, choose neutral, decrease the contrast, decrease the saturation. If you want to see the result, check out our product shoot video. We shot it with a low budget camera. We will put the link in the description. So guys, this is how you do the settings in the camera. Now let's move on to know how to edit and color grade the video. Now, coming to editing screen. Welcome to Premiere Pro 2019, where we edit all our videos. Let's begin. So we are going to walk you through the edits. We have already edited this video, so I will show you how we did it. First, drag the clip into the timeline. Add an adjustment layer on top of the clip. Move the playhead over to the right. Stop where I snap my finger and take the blade and cut out the adjustment layer. On top, you can see an option called color. If you can't find color, go to Windows, Workspace and enable color. You can find Lumetri tab on the right side. Before starting color grading, go to the left side, click on Lumetri scopes. And on the settings, choose waveform. Make sure your waveform type is Luma. Enable it and enable Parade RGB. First, we need to bring the contrast. Click on the adjustment layer. Go to RGB curves. Click on white. This white line affects the luminance of the image. And if you click up the top one and drag it over, you can see it makes the image more brighter. We don't want to increase too much because our clip already has enough brightness. As I do that, it raises up the Luma waveform closer to 100. That's all we want to do. You don't have to bring it all the way to 100. Till here, it's fine for us. And also to bring this down to 0 to create more contrast on the opposite end. I am going to drag this to the right and you can see it brings a lot more shadows in contrast. That's how you adjust the brightness and contrast of the image. Moving on to hue versus saturation. Hue represents color. Pick this dropper tool and select any color. Let's take this red and it will create 3 dots from which we can adjust the saturation. So if I drag this up, it will increase the saturation. drag it down, it will decrease the saturation. This way you can choose which color needs to be saturated and which one is to be desaturated. You can see how we did it here. Try to make each color balanced. You can check this parade RGB in the Lumetri curves. Next, hue versus hue. If you want to change any color, you can use. We don't want this. Next is hue versus luma. It allows you to adjust brightness of a particular color. We did some adjustments here. We wanted to adjust brightness of the lipstick and small adjustments on her skin. Luma versus saturation. It controls the brightness of the saturation. Use it accordingly. Now, saturation versus saturation. This is to control saturation of saturated areas. You play with the saturation of colors here. Now we can move on to the basic color correction. Let's change the white balance. We added little blue to our video, not too much, and highlights just balance over exposed areas and adjust shadows, white, black and saturation. This is the before and this is the after. You can change these according to your video. Don't need to use the exact values that we have used. It won't work like that. And like your wish, play with this and don't forget to check the waveform and parade RGB. If you want to equalize the color and exposure of your video, make sure it is balanced. Next, coming back to the editing tab, add another adjustment. Go to opacity, click onto that ellipse mask tool and draw the mask around your subject and click invert. Now, click onto that adjustment layer. So whatever you adjust in this layer, it will only affect outside our mask. Decrease the exposure a bit. Contrast increase to 38.1. Decrease the shadows and increase blacks and saturation and change the feather to 527. This will help you to pop up your subject. Here is the before and the after. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and please comment in the comment section if you have any doubts. Needless to say, please like, share and subscribe and hit the bell icon. We will come up with new videos on every Wednesday. Support us on Instagram and see you until next episode.